Is the 2021 Jordan 11 Cool Grays worth it? Hey everybody, I'm Actors, and welcome back to the only channel on YouTube that covers in-depth videos of cars and sneakers, and today we're going to be answering that question. And before I unbox these sneakers, I just want to give a special shout out to 39 Castles. My bro Woody over there hooked me up with an early sneaker review. This is my first time I'm reviewing a sneaker before it actually releases. And it's all thanks to the special support I get over there. 39 Castles is amazing. If you guys are ever in St. Louis and looking for a dope shop to shop for sneakers, 39 Castles is definitely the way to go. Now, like and share for that YouTube algorithm and subscribe, and let's unbox these bad boys. First of all, I just want to talk about the box real quick. Hold up, this is how boxes should be. Thank you, Jordan Brand, for not giving us something basic. Like, I was just talking about the Jordan 12 royalties, how they gave us just a normal basic box. They kind of look like this. You know, just a normal standard box. This one actually feels special to the release. We got the Air Jordan logo right there with a white Jumpman with a light gray lid and a dark gray bottom. Kind of matches the sneaker a little bit. This is awesome. I like seeing shit like this. Keep it up. Makes the sneaker feel real special. Now let's lift up that lid, remove that wrapping paper, and whoo! Whoo, damn. You can't name a sneaker more clean than these. I mean, just look at these. Just amazing. Here is a closer look at these bad boys. Some background information about the Cool Grey 11s. This sneaker released originally back in 2001, and now 20 years later they are re-releasing. Also, not to forget to mention, there was another release of these back in 2018. I remember them very vividly, the Jordan 11 Cool Greys, but there were the low versions then. Also want to mention, the original Cool Grey 11s retailed for $125. The lows retail for $175, and these ones are going to retail for $225. These sneakers have inflated over $100 since its last release. But is this sneaker worth the extra $100? Let's go over that by talking about the styling real quick, starting with the sole of the shoe. Jordan 11s are known for their icy outsole, and this one is no exception. This one is, I feel like, a little bit more blue and kind of more translucent than previous releases. It's definitely more of a vibrant blue, or should I say cool blue? Okay, never mind. Anyways, so we also have hints of gray in the front here and the rear. We have a white Jumpman behind the translucent sole, and also carbon fiber. Pretty nice carbon fiber too. Swimming up to the midsole of this sneaker, it's done in all this white foam. And the midsole of a Jordan 11, if you guys know, it's super sculpted. Also, the Jordan 11 is also based off of Ferraris and cars, which I absolutely love. And you can definitely see it. This sneaker, almost said this car, this sneaker looks like it's been strapped down and put through a wind tunnel. Definitely has kind of like an aerodynamic look to it. Anyways, the midsole is super spongy, but also is really prone to creasing a lot. As you can tell, the sneaker is already starting to crease up, and it's not even been worn once. Cut up to the uppers of the sneaker. Now this is why we are all here. We have two shades of gray on the sneaker. A lighter gray on the top, kind of done in a durabuck, and a darker gray on the bottom layers, done in a patent leather. That signature Jordan 11 patent leather. Gives the sneaker such a sleek yet classy look. Kind of waves around the entire sneaker with a little seam sticking out right there. The edges of the leather is more, the cuts on the edges of the leather is definitely more pronounced. Kind of gives the sneaker more of a handcrafted vibe. Trying to zoom in to see what I'm talking about here. I mean, whew, super premium right here. Also, another thing to note about the patent leather is how the leather is cut. It's definitely cut higher and not as slim as the previous releases, so it kind of gives more of an OG look. Super comparable to the Jordan 11 bread. I mean, these things are almost identical in silhouette and cut styling. I hear a lot of people do prefer like the lower cut because it kind of gives a little bit more sleekness and sportiness to the shoe. However, I kind of like the thicker cut just because I'm an OG addict and I like when things kind of retain to the original. Also premium is the upper of the sneaker. It's not leather, it is durabuck, and a really soft feeling durabuck too. I really like it too. It also has that kind of like that Jordan 12 effect where it kind of waves out a little bit right here. I mean, it's just so nice how they integrated the eyelids like that. Each one is sewed on with some mesh and it's, ooh, just adds to the overall design of the sneaker. Let's talk a little bit more about the middle of the sneaker. One, it's got white laces and this is the only pair of laces that we got. And you know, I think it works pretty well with the sneaker. You know, the sneaker could have used more white and they added that with the laces. I mean, we could have probably had some gray laces or something like that, but I think the white, you know, would contrast the best. The tongue of the shoe is also done in all Durabuck and we have a Air Jordan patch right there in the middle with the white Jumpman. Pretty nice. I love that detail. We haven't talked too much about the heel of the sneaker, so let's get it real quick. The heel of the sneaker is probably one of the best heels of any Jordan. I really love the Jordan 11 heel so much. I mean, there's a lot going on here. It's the way how the patent leather kind of waves in. The Durabuck, the lateral side has a white Jumpman right there. It's embroidered too, so that guy's not going anywhere. However, the 23 on the back here is not embroidered, and this is notorious for rubbing off. So that's one thing to look out for if you're wearing these sneakers. But it's still nice that they have the 23 on it. Finish up the styling of the sneaker, let's talk about the sock liner. It kind of seeps a little bit in the heel right here, and it's all done in that darker gray. The interior is all that darker gray, and I'm trying to show you on the camera. There is a gray insole right there with a white Jumpman. This is definitely a really nice and well-made sneaker. It's got great styling and great materials, and also it'll be really easy to style too. How I would style this sneaker would probably be really simple. I mean, I'm kind of wearing the outfit right now. Gray hoodie, you know, washed out jeans, white socks, you know, kind of keep it neutral and contrasting with the sneaker. Obviously, the sneaker could probably be worn a lot differently with a multiple different types of outfits just because the gray nature of the shoe. But that's just how I would style the sneaker. Also, if you're looking to buy this sneaker, they say go true to size for this sneaker. However, I feel that the Jordan 11 is pretty narrow and I like the size up. When I have Jordan 11s, I feel like that fits a little bit more comfortable for me, but my feet just could be different. Maybe, you know, true to size works best for most people. That's just not in my case though. So that's one thing to look out for, trying a pair of Jordan 11s to see how your feet will fit it. So yeah, if I had to rate the sneaker in a scale between 1 and 10, this is a 9 out of 10 sneaker right here. I mean, the Jordan 11 is a beautiful silhouette. The cool gray is a beautiful colorway, and the materials don't disappoint. Do I think it's worth the $225 retail? Yes, but just barely. You know, they are kind of getting expensive on us, but I still think it's worth it. And I do think it's going to be worth paying resale for the sneaker. So let's talk about the future of the sneaker, you know, where the sneaker is heading. And there's a lot of stock to the sneaker. Like over 1 million pairs, and that is going to hurt resale value. You know, that's gonna, you know, creep up on people. A lot of people are gonna buy a lot of pairs thinking they can sell them for hundreds of dollars over retail. I don't think that's going to be the case. I think at most the sneaker will go for $300-$350. I don't think they're going to go over $400 for resale. So just nudging out $100 over retail, I think the sneaker will go for. In the future, definitely this is a hold. I do think like a year or maybe two from now, this sneaker will probably definitely go over $400 and maybe even hit $500. But I think it's gonna take quite a bit because there's so many of these pairs. So it's not gonna be within 6 months. It's gonna take probably a year or two. Yeah, I think that's all there is to it to this sneaker. So the Jordan 11 Cool Gray. What'd you guys think about it? Comment down below your opinion. Like and share for that YouTube algorithm as well as subscribe. I may or may not exit with some on-feet footage. I probably will, so let's get to it.